allowed to join.
Too young and gangly. Amar wouldn't even show me where his hideout is.
Tell me a bit about this Amar.
Likes her ale the way kittens like milk. Spends her time getting tiddly on the docks, chatting up passersby.
I will speak to her. Perhaps Thorstein will regret not letting you in his gang.
Listen to me. If you're smart, you won't cross Amar. She's a vicious fighter.
Soon in. Enjoying her ale. Likely to be a mob. What are you drinking, friend?
The finest ale in town. I like fine things, so you have my attention. What are you doing here, darling?
Looking for a good drink and good company.
You've stumbled into the right ale house. Excellent ale and better conversation.
The ale leads to chatting. Leads to... well, who knows?
Ooh, let's find out.
Is that all you can do?
Ooh, you are wicked!
You are a compelling woman. What is it you do?
You may have heard of Thorstein. I'm one of his most trusted friends.
I have heard of him. Very impressive that he trusts you.
He's like a brother to me. A not very bright brother. He entrusted me with a key to his secret lair.
He has a lair? I would very much like to see that.
Over in Dubaill Landing? Sorry. Thorstein would get all pouty. But perhaps you'd like to join me for a meet.
I'd rather join you for something else.
Can't wait to find out what that is. But hold that thought. I don't feel well. I best move about a bit.
Won't be gentle. I need to get that key from her. If I'm careful, I can avoid a fight.
Hey! What are you up to?
Yeah.
too trusting fool. Your key is mine. Now to find Thorstein's hideout. Survey the area, Sunan. You made a mistake when you came for Barith, Makiva.
Oh, gods! You plan to kill me? Give my head to whatever Irish master you and Barith serve?
I serve no Irish master.
Bullscat! If you had any Norse loyalty, you'd be like me, running the filthy god-eaters from the island. The King of Dublin should look out for Vikings. Not try to make nice with those cunts who killed our forebears. Join me. I could use someone with real balls, and the silver is good.
Be silent, and I might show you mercy. This area is off limits.
Má að eignast stunga hann.
common refuse. Delivered to your judgment, King Barith.
Thorstein, author of the plot to waylay me and my cousin.
Well, you know how it is, Barith. A fellow needs some silver. A king could fetch Dublin's treasury in ransom. Although I'm not certain you'd bring in quite so much.
Say so, Barith, and I will cut out his insolent tongue.
On your feet, Thorstein. You bloody my floors. It is a weighty decision. I would have my closest friend advise me. Eivor, how shall I deal with this ruffian?
People delight in public spectacle. Torture the man until he cannot walk, and no one will dare crush you again.
Well said, Eivor.
I want no blood feud lasting generations, Thorstein. You are not worth the bother. Dublin confiscates your land and silver. I banish you forevermore. Be gone by sundown.
Bend the knee and show your thanks.
Best to you, King. I've better places to be than Dublin.
Father! Why choose weakness?
Give every enemy a length of rope. Soon they will carry your noose.
Peace! Flann Sinna will soon rule all Ireland. Flann Sinna has the power to make or undo my kingship and that of my son. He is the center of all. But Flann distrusts me. He does not believe I'm truly Christian. By showing Christian mercy, I begin to change his mind.
You are more shrewd than I took you for, cousin. Maybe Thorstein's release is worth a kingdom, but will mercy be enough?
That is why I must build trade. Flann will see that the strength of Dublin's ports is the strength of Ireland.
Show him the power of that trade, cousin. Obtain some rare item from afar, some spice or gem or weapon.
And gift it to him at the coronation. It will represent Dublin's reach and help secure my crown.
Flann will hear of your Christian mercy. Meantime, I will speak to Azar about a gift.
Meet me before the coronation. We will go together.
Eivor, welcome to my shop.
I came to ask a favor.
It is pleasant to strengthen friendships. What do you seek?
Barith wishes to show Flann the value of Dublin's trade. Could we obtain a gift from a distant land?
This is the very problem vexing me. You see, I have acquired land in Rathdown, previously owned by Thorstein, in fact. But the land has gone to Thorn and Dog, smugglers as well. Once cleared, its trading route will serve our heart's desire.
In this case, my heart desires an exotic gift, which would be...
A spice merchant I know covets pelts of fine fur. Rathdown has an abundance. It is a perfect match.
Spice is a gift fit for a king. Thank you, Azar.
It is north of here. You go clear it of smugglers while I sit on my ass. No need for thanks.
Rathdown is north of Dublin. I should journey there.
Hmm.
must be careful now. You're one of Azar's men.
I am. Azar tells me you two are interested in furs to trade for a gift.
Ill shocking flaunt the reach of Barith's trade.
We'll get the furs you need.
How can I help?
With trade post supplies. We'll build up the post for better and faster trade.
Where would I get these supplies?
Monasteries are a good place. They'll have what you need.
I'm curious how you and Azar work together.
I gather pelts, treat them, and send the fur to Dublin. Azar trades them across the seas. We want to build up the post, both to send bundles of furs to Azar more often, and to store more to send.
Ireland must have many trading posts.
It does. Each post trades specific goods. Here, we gather furs. But elsewhere, all manner of things.
Thank you, friend.
Goodbye, Eivor.
Show me what lies ahead. Yeah. See you, old friend. Let's go. More sails!
Strain to Valhalla pay. Then horns resound the mighty hall.
Let's go, Viking!
Ah!
Show me.
Can't hold out much longer! Help me with this! Stretch your wings, Sunan.
same.
By your smile that the expedition was fruitful. Should we build something? Well done. We'll send the force to Dublin. Azar will help you find more posts to capture.
Goodbye, friend.
Eivor, the furs have arrived from Rathdown. We can now trade for Flann's gift. Come, check the storage.
Azar, you have your trade post.
In fact, I have heard from the trader himself. We have furs enough for Flann's gift. Here, my friend. Make the trade. Fine spices that cannot be obtained anywhere else. I will see them delivered for the coronation. Flann will certainly grasp the strength of Dublin's trade. Speaking of, Eivor, there are abandoned trade posts across Ireland.
You're suggesting I claim them to increase Dublin's reach?
We will gain access to goods we could not otherwise obtain. There is great bounty to be had.
I will look for opportunities. Meanwhile, I'll find Barrett. He'll be pleased to hear Flann's gift.
Stop.
far enough to steal a plowing from him.
Hey, do you eat at me, noom?
Exact na cowl. Ek wait, take it.
Bareth, Flann's gift is on its way to Meath.
Very good. I was just preparing to leave for the coronation, though I now have a problem on my hands.
What is it?
Flann's poetess, Kira. She was here delivering a formal invitation, and now I do not know where she's gone.
Do you think she's in trouble?
No, I think she is amusing herself somewhere, likely perusing Dublin's markets. We need her. The High Poetess is an important member of the King's Court. There cannot be a coronation without one.
I will find her. Where should we meet?
By Dublin's gates. I will ready the horses.
Aid me, be my eyes.
For the sake of our ears, shut your mouth!
Sure, and you're an idiot.
You are all the same.
Grab the bitch!
Fay, won't you let a caged bird sing?
Shit.
I'd hoped an audience of tone-deaf Danes might permit.
Are you Kira?
Hold her down!
Wonder of wonders. How much trouble can I be in at once?
Can't help you. This one comes with me.
No, no, no! She will answer for this insult!
Can change your mind? You owe me. Has made friends with the ground. On your feet, poetess.
Everything is spinning.
A cold bath will remedy this quickly. To flush the ale from you. If you think I'm going to lock you to Tara, you're mistaken.
Tara? Wait! Who are you?
Barret sent me to collect you. He's waiting at the stables.
Ah, an envoy. Tell me, how much coin would an envoy be wanting to speak nothing of this brawl to Barret? He'll tie a guard to my hip the next time I'm in Dublin. Man can be so sensitive sometimes, do you know what I mean?
I do. Barith is my family.
Well then, I think my mouth has gotten me in enough trouble today.
Try opening it less. Works for me. Shall we?
Barith has never spoken of you. What name do you bear?
Eivor. I hail from Norway, now settled in England with the rest of my clan.
A clan, eh? Are they all fist thumpers like you?
It is because of these fists you live to sing another day, poetess.
So true. Barith.
I was beginning to worry. What took?
There was trouble.
Ara, no need to be so tense. Shall we ride for Tara? We don't want to be late for the coronation.
After you.
I was surprised to meet a member of your family, Barith. Eivor tells me she's come from England.
Yes, Eivor is helping to establish trade in Dublin, secure valuable resources with faraway lands. In time, Dublin will become the heart of Ireland's trade, one that each and every kingdom can benefit from.
That will no doubt please the future High King.
Yes, well, above trade, I am hoping Flann can see Dublin as a friend and ally.
You and many others.
A relationship with Barith would be one worth fostering. It would be foolish of your king to ignore it.
It appears Eivor is not abreast with our kingly history, Barith.
We were hoping to have a meeting with Flann. My wish is to strengthen our ties. Can you see it done?
Perhaps. We will see how the evening goes. Quite the event, hmm?
Spared no expense, that much is clear.
Ara, my lady, one of the priests has gone missing. A violent mess is left of his tent. I fear something terrible has happened.
Missing? Are you sure?
Could be nothing. Could mean danger. Where is Flann?
He's not yet arrived.
That gives us some time. Kira, act as if nothing were amiss. Barith and I will look into it. Where is this tent?
Up the hill, to the left.
Be careful.
Hello.
There was a fight here.
It is the eve of the coronation, and already trouble brews.
Keep your wits and stay close. We do not know anything yet. Something dark happened here. We must follow the blood. A succulent roast. Let us go back and follow another trail.
The blood leads off away from the main camp. Perhaps towards those tents?
Blood stops here. Where do these cart tracks lead?
This story is like to have a poor ending.
I fear so, cousin.
On such a momentous day as well. Flan's coronation may not be as hoped.
There. A cart up ahead. Looks like they hit a snag. Recognize him?
That is Senan, the priest. Bastard stripped him of his clothes.
That camp up there. What is it?
Anakhtu is no camp, though it appears someone has made it into one.
Let's go.
What do you think?
The priest was kidnapped. They took his clothes. I believe whoever did this means to wear them.
A disguise?
We will soon find out. That one is dressed as the priest. Follow my lead.
Turn away now.
Go, Sunan.
Oh. I'll kill you!
Bleeding!
Sent to kill Flan. The letter is unsigned. An unknown enemy. Come. We must bring news of this to Kira.
I'm with you. You handled yourself well, Eivor, I have to say. You really are no stranger to these sorts of encounters.
You did not do so bad yourself.
Aye, we stopped the death of a king this day. If only we knew who was behind it.
No idea who would go to such lengths.
You can take your pick of the Northern E-Nail Kings, though it is the Kings of Ulster who particularly dislike Flann.
Different king. Same story.
Any story?
The priest is dead, and so too are his killers, bandits. I found this. It's an order to kill Flann. One of them was to disguise himself as a priest. Cut Flann's throat during the coronation.
Right under our noses.
Why take the risk? Why not poison? Or striking at him in his sleep?
Poison can fail. And to kill him in his sleep lacks spectacle. But your point is sound. The killer would not have made it out alive. He was ready to die. Whoever plotted this is intent on seeing Flann fall. We need to warn him.
After the coronation, I will not have this gnawing at him. Flann earned this. He will enjoy it. Meet him afterward at his quarters in Durrow. He will make time for you there. Now, if you will take my excuses, I need to tidy up.
Come along, Eivor.
The water was not that murky, was it?
You don't know much about the role of a poetess, do you, Eivor?
Enlighten me.
I will. Well, what are you waiting for? I asked to be excused. That meant you as well.
I see other kings here. News of Flan's inauguration has reached far and wide. Come, we should join them.
Is that him, Flan?
Yes.
What are they doing?
Blessing him. Abbot Owen is the highest-ranking official among the Christians. His blessing asserts that Flan is ready to fill the boots of his predecessor. It is all done before the Lia fall, a sacred stone that is said to endow the rightful kings with long reigns.
Does it work?
Depends on what you consider long.
Coronations are long. Where is the food?
You have not changed.
I am here. I may as well enjoy myself.
Flan for edin yeji koke.
That, Flan's enemies multiply.
This warring of dynasties runs deep. If he's a smart king, he'll be eager for allies.
Smart he is, but also impassioned. His plan to subdue the north is not driven by power so much as it is bloodlust.
Back there on our ride from Dublin, Kira made it seem there was more to you and Flan. What am I missing?
A large detail. You see, the northern king who crowned me, Ed Findlia, he murdered Flan's father and took his place as High King. Then, as is custom, he married Flan's mother.
Safe to say there is no love lost between you.
None. To Flan, Ed was a venomous snake, and so too are the ones he favored. Winning his trust will be no simple task.
We just thwarted an attempt on his life. That should at least perk his ears up.
Let us hope. I will leave immediately for Duro. Meet me there as soon as you can.
Relax your shoulders. He has as much to gain from this as we do.
Welcome you to Duro. It has been a long time.
Thank you for meeting with me, Lord. I trust our gift was well received.
Exotic spices, all of which are foreign to me. I am impressed.
Only a taste of things to come. Dublin will soon be known as the pillar of Ireland's trade. To a long life and prosperous reign, my king.
Such fealty. You honor me. You must be Azar. My gratitude for your selfless actions in what preceded my coronation.
Lord?
It seems my enemies could not wait for my reign to begin before trying to put an end to it. An old tale between Northern and Southern Eanail, I'm afraid. But it's one whose ending I will be the author of.
Planning a war?
A High King should have control over his land. And I shall. If it takes a bloody war, I must be prepared for it.
Dublin's trade has plenty to offer and plenty of stout fighters, Azar included, ready to fight alongside you.
I appreciate your desire to strengthen the ties between Meath and Dublin. And as much as I find myself in need of aid, it appears you find yourself undermined by your own people.
What do you mean?
During the coronation, a monastery was raided and a Christian text was lost. The Book of Kells. Dublin Danes are to blame. Your support would be of great help, let me be clear. But this capriciousness will sooner harm me than help me.
I take it the book is important.
Authored by monks from the monastery of Iona some 80 years ago it was. After the Danes first reached our shores. It was meant to preserve the Christian faith in uncertain times. Today, it is a symbol of that perseverance.
If I retrieve the book, set straight the ones who did this. Would you welcome Barath into your court?
It would help.
These Danes, you know where they are?
In a bog in Inchro, just north of here.
Azar! This is my responsibility.
Remain here. I'll see it done. Have a look, Sunan. Be my eyes, Sunan. Inchro spark. Inchro spark. These are the ones who stole the Book of Kells. I should search their stashes for it. Seen in this area. go, my eyes. Not what I'm looking for. My friend.
It's you!
It's you! Though we told you to leave, Thorstein.
Leave Dublin? Correct me if I'm wrong, but this is not Dublin.
You did not understand you are not to be seen again.
Oh, come now. How was I to know you would find your way out here? Why are you here?
Looking for a book you stole. You raided a monastery recently.
Oh, it was several monasteries, actually. These new friends of mine do not tire easily.
The book is important to the Christians. I need it back.
The Christians? Ha! See? You are an Irish lapdog. I do not have it. Are you upset? Please do not be upset. You are upset,
I am running out of reasons to let you live.
I know where it is. Boyne Tombs. Some strange folks offered me this hoard for it. I could not resist. Could you? See? You understand. We are very alike, you and I. I could just as well be your brother. Do not kill me.
Thorstein, your blood is not worthy of my steel.
I could not agree more.
Now vanish. I mean it this time. A third encounter you will not walk away from.
Oh, I am through with Ireland. My ankles ache for how I must dance around all these kings. It offers nothing. Except for this. I will just take this. And this.
God. Must be blocked from the other side. Need to get on the other side. Thank you. asked about this land, my friend.
to you. Thank you.
Boyne tombs. Thorstein said I could find the Book of Kells here.
Book. Have you found it?
Its popularity is ever increasing.
This is Owen, Abbot of Armagh. The book is for him.
I remember, from the coronation.
I pray you did not have to endure much to reclaim this.
A small price to ensure the High King's patronage.
What's this? Lord. You are chosen High King by God Almighty. These are pagans. I mean no disrespect.
You have no say here. This is between the two kings.
I only mean to warn Flan of the possible implications.
nothing more.
And I am well aware of them, Abbot.
I have spoken past what is right. I will take my leave. Lord, please excuse this clumsy intrusion.
No need. I am glad to see the book is back in good hands.
He is colorful.
I do not blame the Abbot for raising alarm. History dictates he has every reason to. What is your report?
I have dealt with the leader in the bog. You'll have no more problems coming out of Dublin.
Then we shall turn our eyes to the problem at hand. Ulster is using its power to sway Connacht, an allegiance that must be snuffed before it takes flame. For that, we need to gain support from the other kingdoms. Speak with Kira. She will guide you in this.
I shall return to Dublin to gather men and resources for the march.
I welcome them. When we are strong enough, we'll meet at Knockfree and devise a strategy.
You were gone some time. What happened?
The book was in the hands of a strange cult. They procured it from Thorstein.
I was weak to spare him. My own son knew better.
Chin up, Barith. We have come into favor with the High King.
I will feel better the day Flan's trust in me is not shadowed by doubt. Back to Dublin I go. Talk to Kira. We must gain favor with the other kings. Quickly.
Eat any good mice lately?
I am glad to see you.
Thank you.
I reckon Flan and Barath have found common ground, seeing as you're still here.
They have.
Ara, and how much of your charm seeped into that conversation?
I merely showed the High King I'm a Norse he can trust.
It is more than that. You've certainly left your mark here. Sure, I think Flan is fond of you.
Is he the only one?
You're not shy, are you?
Just perceptive. We need to curry favor with as many kingdoms as we can. Flan said you could help with that.
Aye. The kings of Ireland have long sent their grievances to the High King's court in hopes their pleas be heard. Their problems range from petty squabbles to larger issues. I've taken the liberty of sifting through them, choosing the ones that might elicit the best response.
I see. The bigger the favor, the bigger the reward.
There you have it. Keep an eye out for pigeon coops. That's where I'll leave any noteworthy tasks. Help solve their woes, and the kings will pay tribute with the men and supplies we need to invade Ulster.
Sunan, guide me.
Celestine! thing. Thank you.
What do you see, Sunan? See you, old friend. Thank you.
Rathdown herbs. Powerful seed.
cast about with land, my friend. Stretch your wings, Suman.
Scum!
Kill the car flags!
Wait a sec!
That's enough!
Thank you. So I need to complete a favor for another king. I should check pigeon coops for any leads.
Leather.
Near Bowmore, the lead a trade, the verid er a mare in over a gallina.
As for Kerry, don't for some valve carting.